It finally happened. After years of NASA saying it could happen any day now, the Voyager 1 probe has officially left the solar system.
This is one of those journeys of exploration, like circumnavigating the globe for the first time or having a footprint on the moon the first time.
That's Ed Stone, the NASA scientist who has headed up the Voyager project for more than 40 years and who had a big grin on his face during NASA's press conference Thursday afternoon. It's not hard to see why. The 1,600-pound Voyager 1, launched in 1977, has had a long and storied career, sending back some of the earliest close-up images of Jupiter and Saturn and taking the famous pale blue dot photo of Earth.
Every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there, on the mote of dust, suspended in a sunbeam.
And now Voyager 1 has made history by becoming the first human-made object to reach interstellar space. Well, we say now, but scientists estimate the probe actually left our solar system in late August of last year, but it took a while to figure it out. Popular Science explains, the border of the heliosphere isn't visible. It's not like breaking through the tape at the end of a marathon and knowing you're finished and on the other side, which could explain why we've been seeing headlines like these for years. But now that NASA has finally chimed in and made it official, it's time for the congratulations. One scientist working on the project told National Geographic, in the same way that Sputnik carried us out of the Earth's atmosphere in 1957, Voyager has now carried us outside the sun's atmosphere. Star Trek stars Will Wheaton and William Shatner both shared their excitement on Twitter. And a lineup of big names in astronomy and sci-fi, including Neil deGrasse Tyson, appeared in a video from NASA. Now that humanity is an interstellar species, you might be interested in the message we've sent out into the stars. Voyager 1 has a special payload, a golden record filled with images and sounds from Earth, including pictures of landscapes, cities, and people, sounds like the rain, music, and laughing children, greetings in 55 languages, and the brainwaves of a person in love. The probe has enough power to send back data into the mid-2020s, then it'll float silently through interstellar space. It'll pass near a foreign star in around 40,000 years. For Newsy, I'm Candace Aviles.